Well, I cut two edges almost down to nothing, about less than a quarter of an inch, because the trailer is 3/4 inch lower in the back than in the front, and that's to support the back end where the tailgate is. So this is 3/4 to make up for the 3/4 difference in it. That's a 3/4 inch board, and it's been glued and screwed. And then I have drilled holes through all of these, about every 8 inches, all the way around three sides. I don't have to drill it back there because that's where the tailgate's going to go. And if you can picture this side, if we were to just lay this over this away and put it on top of that trailer, of course this board needs to be flipped first, but where these screw holes are will screw into that 2x4, and then the floor will be right here and it'll be flush, and that will be the outside and you won't be able to see the floor. Well, I finally got the ends done. That's the tailgate. It's a 3/4 inch gap all the way around three sides, and the top is flat. And the hasp will go up here, which will help hold the box together in the back, and the hinges will go on that end. And this is the front of the box. Raise this up and get rid of the shadows. And it's offset 2 3/4 inches. And 3/4 on the bottom, and the top is flat. So the whole trailer is flat, and all the sides extend 3/4 inch past the deck, the floor, which is under all that cardboard. And these 2x4s is just to give strength to that plywood and keep it primarily from warping. And that's the two sides. We did have some really rough looking plywood. They needed to change the planing blades a little bit earlier than they did. And so all I gotta do is flip that over, put the front on it first, and I might have to run a board from the front to over here somewhere and just temporarily hold it in place, and then put the sides on it and hook the sides to that end. And then I can put the hinges on it and put the tailgate on it, and that'll be just about it. Well, my bride was down here with me today. We had to come down and finish up a few little items in the garden and dig up all our dahlias and protect our hens and chickens that were out front, and put all the deck furniture back on the finished deck. And it's 4:45 on Saturday the 15th of November, and what we did is we set this on and it overlaps the floor, and my bride held it in place, and I screwed it in the bottom into one of those, that 2x4, and then I didn't need anybody to support it. Then we put this side on, and I screwed it in through the bottom, and we did have to use these clamps. I've got these two long clamps, they're probably 5 footers, because that's a 4 foot box, maybe 4.5 footers. And we had to pull it in because there was a certain amount of warpage in the 2x4s and the plywood, and to make that seam go across the bottom, we had to put this clamp on the bottom. We have two of them, and this side was up a little bit, so we had to put a clamp here just to bring it down, because the screws, it would be too much for the screws to pull. And so we put a clamp across here and mated that up really smooth and screwed it in and kept moving the clamp all the way down until it was done. And we did the same thing with the other side. You can see where the clamps that hold it on a trailer go, and there'll be some in the back. And right now we're in the process of mounting the tailgate. And I have a bunch of hinges that I beat out, and I haven't sanded and painted my front inner and outer braces, but I have bought new hasp for it, and I can mount those. And that's about it on this box.